And I think we're recording.
Hello everybody, thank you for joining us today. Apologies for the delay. We've had quite a few people who've been trying to log on, so we want to make sure we had as many people as possible joining us today. We're really glad you've joined in. We apologize it has to be virtual in the current climate that we're living with this COVID, so this was the safest option for everybody. But rest assured, once the children do decide to come here, they will have visits to the school. Our staff will go and visit in the primary schools, and they'll have as much access as they possibly can here, because hopefully this nasty virus will go away soon. I'm going to hand over to Mr. Cook, who is our head of school, and he's going to have a couple of words with you. And then the format for today is we've got a very brief presentation and then a video of the school, just so that you can have a little tour of the school and see what it's like and meet the departments. And then we'll be here at the end of the video for any questions you may have. So over to you, Mr. Cook.
Is that okay, just to go?
Here we go.
Good afternoon, everyone. Apologies about the technical difficulties, and I guess that sums up the situation we're in. Welcome to you all. Thanks for joining us. I'm Matthew Cook. I'm head of school at Cwmbran. And firstly, apologies that you're not able to come and join us, and it is a little bit different today in terms of how we do these open evenings, but it is a pleasure that you've joined us and that we get this opportunity to meet in this strange way, which is not normal, but I guess nothing is normal, okay? Just a little bit of information about school and how the school runs firstly. Mrs. Gill, who was hoping to join us tonight, is executive head teacher. So she runs two schools, one in Cardiff and Cwmbran, and I'm head of school, so I'm here full time. I'm here all week. So I'm looking forward to meeting your sons and daughters over the next coming weeks and hopefully months. And as Miss has already said, it'd be lovely soon that they can come and join us and see the school. It is probably the next best thing today. So you're able to see what our school looks like. You're going to be able to meet departments in a different way, but you'll be able to see what facilities we've got and how the school runs from day to day. And I think the best opportunity is going to be just at the end of that evening is to have those conversations and ask any questions that you've got to ask the staff, that we'll be on hand just to answer those questions for you. You're bound to have little things that you may be concerned with or information that you want to know, and that's why we're here tonight, just to join you. So that we can answer those questions. Okay, so welcome. There's lots of information that's going to be passed to you now in the next hour or so. We'll be on hand just at the end to answer those questions. Okay, thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Okay, just bear with me and I'll get myself set. Okay, so I'm going to now share with you just a short PowerPoint. Again, I'm not the technical one here. I normally have a little saying, if in doubt, give it a clout, when my laptop stops working. So bear with me and hopefully we will have the PowerPoint on screen very, very shortly. From the start would be nice. So Mrs. Abdullah is just about to pop out of the room, but she will rejoin us very, very shortly. She's our deputy head teacher. And she will be responsible for overseeing all of the transition in the next for your children in the next few months. Myself, I'm Mrs. Haynes. I'm head of Year 7 and I lead with transition as regards meeting the children and meeting the members of staff in their primary schools. So welcome to all of you. We're really sad that we can't meet you in person. We always prefer to see everybody face to face. But such as it is, we wanted to do the best that we can under the circumstances. And hopefully this will just give you a flavour this evening of Cwmbran High School. If you decide to bring your child here, as Mrs. Abdullah and Mr. Cook have already said, we will have lots more contact with them and with you if it is required. So I am, as I said, head of Year 7. I've been head of Year 7 for quite a long time now. Some schools have a head of Year 7 that moves through with the year group. We find that because I have built such strong relationships with primary schools, it works very well for us that I welcome children into the school in Year 7. And the general pattern is then that children, as they go into Year 8, will have a new head of year who will take them through school. It doesn't always happen if there are handovers and changeovers of staffing, but that's the general picture. I think it's also because I'm like mum at school, so as children are having that huge change in their life, they're moving on from primary to secondary school. I think it's nice that they've got somebody at school who's going to be mum. I'm quite strict, quite firm with them, but I'm also very, very caring, and I'm the one who'll give them a bit of an arm around the shoulder if they're a bit sad and upset. Our school is a very pupil-centred school. We're a very friendly school, and what we want is for your children to be safe and happy at school. Our pastoral team in Year 7 is always very strong. We have a team of 8 tutors this year. It's generally 8 tutors, but depending on our intake number, there can be fewer or more tutors. And those form tutors work extremely hard in the first couple of weeks of your children joining us to make sure that they get to know them very well and that they get to know what they like, what they dislike, and they will support your children as very best they can. We understand that communication is a huge issue when children come from primary to secondary school, because we know that you're used to having a huge amount of communication, and that isn't so much in secondary school. But we do try to make the lines of communication as easy as possible, and we always invite parents to contact us if there's anything of concern at all regarding your child. We do want to talk to you about it, and we do want to make sure that we're working together to make sure that everything is working well for your child. Okay, so we also have a transition Google Classroom. We will be sending the link for this Google Classroom out to all of the primary schools within the next couple of weeks. We're just closing down our previous year's one. Obviously, we've got lots of children who are currently now in Year 7 in the classroom, so we need to get a good changeover now. So when your children get the link for the Google Classroom, then they will be able to join us, and in the classroom, all of our subject teachers post little activities, little videos, things that they might want to have a look at, engage with. We also have my virtual classroom, which is on screen now. And the virtual classroom, each of those posters on the wall has a link. It's a direct link to each of those individual activities. So there's tours of the school, there's our copies of Cwmbran Chronicle, and through the Chronicle you can have a little look then at the things that are going on in school. And we also, if you can see on the bookshelf at the left hand side, have copies of our booklet, our information booklet for school. And there is a booklet which we will give you, six pupils, a hard copy of, which just has lots of questions and information for pupils about our school. I will just exit because Mrs. Gill is looking to join us. Let me just see if I can do that for Mrs. Gill.
Because she's been invited as a parent, but she needs to go in as an organiser.
Okay. I don't know how to do that. Bear with us, my apologies. Can invite from there, but I don't know. You can see I'm not very technical minded, so my apologies for the hold-ups.
Really sorry, we're just trying to get Mrs. Gill, our executive head teacher, to be able to join us, because she'd like to speak to you. And unfortunately, the link isn't working. So that's what we're trying to do now. So we think it'd be lovely for you to meet Mrs. Gill, even if it is virtually, as she's our executive head teacher here in the school.
I think Mrs. Gill is in the meeting.
So if you could just bear with us for a second.
Let me just have a look at that.
well.
Okay, hello, Mrs. Gill, are you there now?
Oh, welcome everybody. Apologies for that delay. Technology is not on my side today, I'm afraid.
Nor ours, miss, nor ours.
So I could see you all and hear everything, but clearly you couldn't hear or see me. But thank you everybody, and thank you for your time and your patience this evening. As I know Miss Abdullah has introduced me, I am Mrs. Gill. I'm the executive head teacher here in Cwmbran High School. Absolutely delighted to be able to say hello to you all. Disappointed, obviously, that and probably for very technical reasons, that we can't meet face to face. It would have been so much easier. But I would have really liked the opportunity to show you around Cwmbran, show you around our school, of which we're very proud. And to show you what life could be like for your child if you choose for them to attend our school. I do appreciate, and I always say this, deciding what school your child is going to attend is probably the most difficult decision as a parent you'll have to make about your child's education. And therefore, it's one that you have to do having made an informed choice. In order to do that, you need to have as much information to hand to be able to make that decision. And that's really the purpose of tonight. I'm also aware that transferring from primary to secondary school is always a stress and a challenge, more so for parents actually than children. But that's exacerbated at the moment during COVID when you're not able to get in and see us face to face and meet us. I'm also mindful that there's a lot of information for you to consider. I know Miss Hayes has already presented on some of that and is going to signpost you to more information. And that can be quite overwhelming. So my recommendation to you is to take your time going through the information that you're provided with. Please remember to ask the questions and anything that you want to know, we are on hand to be able to answer. And find out as much as you can about us before you make any decisions. Also, I think it's important to say that you're not alone in this process. And Mrs. Hayes and Mrs. Abdullah are going to actually take you through step by step through the process to ensure that you're able to make that informed decision. When you do make a decision about schools, you need to think about what is right for your child. You don't need me to tell you that. We can talk to you about exam results. We're very proud here in Cwmbran. We are a rapidly improving school. I'm very honoured to be working in the school alongside Mr. Cook and the rest of the staff, who I can assure you are a completely committed team. What we want to do is make sure that you have all the information to hand and that you're able to make that informed decision. We will you'll hear lots about ESTIN over the course of the time, or inspectorate, you'll hear about exam results. But I'm also really mindful that there's more to a school than that exam results. You've got to get a feel for us as well and believe that your child will be happy with us. I think we've got somebody there who can say hello to. I think what I want to get across tonight is not only the support that we provide for your child, but also what our vision is and our ethos for the school. We are a very inclusive school. We are driven by very high aspiration. We want the very best for our children in the school, and therefore the very best for your child. We want them to do very well. We want them to be really happy. We want them to be successful in life, and the aim is to ensure that they have all the skills available to them to go on in later life and do the best for whatever they want to do in their careers. So, as I say, we are able to cater for all children, whether your child is a sports person, a budding artist, a keen musician. We are able to cater for all children through our bespoke curriculum and make sure all their needs are met, including perhaps those with additional learning needs as well. after you've had the information tonight, if there is more information that you would like, and I'm sure you probably will have questions, then please communicate those through to the school, because we do want to answer all the questions that we can. So welcome to this evening. It's been lovely to meet you, albeit briefly, and I do apologise once again for the disruption this morning, earlier on, sorry, but it's lovely to meet you. Please take time to look at our school website and ask any questions, and we're always on hand if you want more information. Thank you. Thank you, Ms. Haynes.
Thank you, Mrs. Gill. We're going to go back to the PowerPoint now. I'm going to try again and be very technical. Thank you so much for your patience. It's very much appreciated, particularly from me. I really am not very very techie minded. So thank you for your patience with that. Let me just pop this back on. There we go. Our Google Classroom, as I said, we will make sure that the code for that is sent out via the primary schools as soon as possible, so that you have the opportunity then to be able to join the Google Classroom. And there you'll be able to, the children will be able to ask us questions, and we will update with lots of information. You might want to take a little snapshot of the screen now with the communication facilities for our school. So the school phone number is there. It's a very busy line, as you can imagine. We've got over 1,000 children in school, so it's very difficult to get hold of reception first thing in the morning and last thing in the afternoon. But sort of midday and throughout the day, it's a little bit easier. If there are any questions, you can contact reception and they will put you in touch with the appropriate person. We use text messages when the children are at school. Obviously, we're not able to contact you via text message at the moment because we don't have any of your contact details. But when the children join us in year 7, we will be able to send text messages to you and keep you updated with things. We have a Facebook and a Twitter page, both of which are there. And I actually also have a transition Twitter page, which you can find linked to the Cwmbran High page. And I always post lots of details on the transition page, and the school website we update with information and dates for your diary, so it's always worth checking in on the school website. Okay, I'm going to attempt now to play a video, so I'm hoping that the sound comes through, but please, if you can't hear it, please let us know in the chat so that I can do my tech thing and have a little go and see if we can get the sound working. I'm sure it will be fine. Any questions then? We will be here right at the end to answer any questions that you might have. Specific questions about your child, if there's something specific, we would prefer to discuss it personally. But if you have general questions, then please don't be afraid to ask at the end of the presentation. I hope you enjoy the video.
Virtual open evening. My name is Tracy Abdullah, and I am very proud to say that I am the deputy head teacher here at Cwmbran High School. It really does give me great pleasure to invite prospective pupils and their families to take a look around our school and experience what we have to offer. Unfortunately, due to local and national restrictions, we're unable to do this in person, but I'm sure this video will provide you with the information that you need.
Hello, I'm Mrs. Haynes, and I'm current head of Year 7. We believe strongly in supporting each individual in their transition to Year 7. This is usually achieved through visits to our school throughout the year, which help our children to settle in well and for staff to get to know them quickly. We want everyone to work hard, enjoy what they do, and be happy in all aspects of school life.
My name is Mrs. Cunnington, and I am head of English here at Cwmbran High School. We're a large team of 10 English teachers, and we offer a range of exciting and interesting lessons. When you come up to Cwmbran High School, you can expect in your English lessons lots of reading, We read for at least 15 minutes of every lesson. You may have heard of the Accelerated Reader Programme, you may have done it in your primary schools, but we continue that here to make sure that we really develop your reading skills and improve your reading ages. Not only this, we study lots of different topics to improve not only your reading, but your writing and oracy skills as well. Anything from Gothic literature, we study a range of different Shakespeare texts, lots of new and exciting novels like The Recruit by Robert Muchamore, as well as non-fiction. We prepare you quite early on for your GCSEs, studying how to write a letter, how to structure a blog, and how to analyse how a writer constructs something. I'm confident that you're going to really enjoy your lessons. We offer lots of extra support, whether that be in class, but also after school and revision activities as well. As a department, we offer GCSE English Literature and English Language. That means that you'll leave the school with two qualifications, so all to play for. We look forward to meeting you.
Hi, Year 6. I'm Miss Aylin and I'm the librarian here at CHS. As you see, we've got a lovely library in the school. When you come to CHS in September, you'll be doing Accelerated Reader. You get to read in every single lesson. We've got loads of books for you to choose from. There's over 11,000 books in the library, so I'm sure there'll be something here you'll enjoy. Looking forward to meeting you in September.
Hi everyone, I'm Mr. Tipmins. I'm head of maths here at Cumbrand High School. Really looking forward to meeting you all next September. We've got 8 members of the maths department, all who have really engaging lessons for you, from using mini whiteboards to using Kahoots to using the iPads, to ensure that when you come to maths you are engaged and do the best that you can do. We've got a curriculum which is designed specifically for pupils of Cumbrand High, because our aim is to make sure that when you leave in year 11 you leave with the best results possible.
Shemai Blwyddyn Chwech for anyway ydy Mrs Neat, and I'm head of Welsh here at Cumbrand High School. Welsh is a compulsory subject, which means you'll be studying it right up to GCSE level. You'll be working with specialist teachers to help you develop your reading, writing, listening and speaking skills in a fun and engaging way. There are plenty of benefits for being bilingual, such as improved memory, confidence and ability in your wider literacy skills. We understand that all learners will have different starting points when starting at Cumbrand High School, but don't worry, we've taught all ranges of learners, from pupils who have lived in Wales all of their lives to students who've lived in different parts of the UK and even across the world. We don't expect you to be fluent. All we ask is that you're up for a challenge and you're positive about learning a new skill. One of my favourite things about being a Welsh teacher is seeing pupils develop in confidence throughout the term and enjoying the subject more and more each lesson. We can't wait to meet you in September. Until then, stay safe, take care, and we'll see you soon. Feel proud.
Bonjour. Oh, hi everyone. I'm Mr. Barbo, Head of Design Technology at Cumbrian High School. You just caught me in the middle of a Year 7 lesson. Anyway, what we're going to be doing is showing you around the department, showing you some of the great work the pupils have previously done, and showing you some of the different subject areas you'll be covering when you arrive in September.
Excuse the noise, but I've just popped over the CAD-CAM corner where I've got the laser cutter behind me, ready to give you a demonstration of what it can do. Now, it can cut a range of materials, which makes it quick and easy to model now using computers. For example, some of these lamps, they were modeled very quickly out of cardboard. I'm just going to hold up here and show you. And they didn't take long to produce very fast prototypes. So, I'm going to give you a quick example now. What I've done here then is I've very quickly drawn up probably the best logo in the world, the CHS badge, and I've used a red line to signal a cut. So if we move over the laser cutter now and I push start, the laser cutter should run and it should cut out this design. You can see how quick it's going. It's going around ever so fast, cutting out the outside of the badge first, then it should run round and cut the letters out. Okay, let's check out how it's done. And there you go, a perfect CHS badge, cut really quickly. You're certainly not going to need these when you've got one of these. And welcome to the kitchen. As you can see behind me, it's been recently refurbished and it hasn't had a great deal of use. So what I need is you in September to come up and get some use out of it.
Head of Computing at Cumbrian High School. This is Miss Miles, one of our other IT teachers here. In Cumbrian we have two IT suites, both with 30 touchscreen computers. All computers also have a Raspberry Pi, where pupils can use them to code Minecraft and Python, for example. We also use lots of robots in lessons. We have Edison robots and Sphero robots, and the following pictures and videos are going to show you some of the pupils using these robots in lesson.
Today this could be the greatest day of our lives. Before it all ends, before we run out of time, stay close to me, stay close to me. Watch the world come alive tonight. Tonight this could be the greatest night of our lives. Let's make a new start. The future is ours to find. Can you see it? Can you see it in my eyes? Can you feel it now? Can you hold?
Croeso, welcome to the PE department. My name is Mr. Bovey. I'm the head of the PE department here at Cumberland High School. We like to think that we're quite fortunate here in the department in that we have a wide range of facilities which enables us to offer lots of different activities to our students. We have full access to the leisure centre during the school day. So we have a large sports hall, a gymnasium, a dance studio, fitness suite and a swimming pool here on site. We also have a large rugby field and football pitch, as well as a multi-use games area and a red grass. As you can see, we're currently studying our sports hall and we've got a group of students playing badminton. In this area, we would also be doing activities such as basketball, five-a-side, netball, trampolining and dodgeball.
Hi, my name's Mrs. Manning and I'm one of the PE teachers at Cumberland High School, also second in department. Currently stood on our fields at the back of the leisure centre. In the winter months, this is the facility we use for football and rugby, and then in the summer for baseball and athletic activities. This is also the venue for our annual sports day, which is a whole school event enjoyed by everyone.
Good morning, I'm Mr. Hine, head of Year 10 and also PE teacher here at Cumberland High School. I'm at the multi-use games area this morning. We've got year 8 groups out here doing some rugby skills this morning, so we can use this area for lots of activities, whether it be netball, hockey, basketball, some stockball and baseball and roundball here as well. So we can do any activity you want in this area. Lucky today, it's nice and dry, and year 8 certainly playing rugby, so hope to see you soon.
Hobbs, one of the PE teachers at Cumberland High School. We're currently in our gymnasium where we do activities such as dance, gymnastics, basketball and some fitness. As you can see, some of the guys are currently doing some fitness behind me.
Hello, my name is Dominic Farr. I'm currently in year 9. And I'm really enjoying PE lately. My favourite PE lessons are football and rugby because they're really fun. I really enjoy PE because it keeps me fit and there's a lot of fun different activities to do. I would like PE to be one of my options in year 9.
Welcome to Performing Arts. My name is Mr. Osborne and I'm the current head of department. I specialise in teaching music, so you can probably expect to see me for your music lessons when you come to Cumberland High next year. In the department, we also have Mr. Brown who teaches drama, Mr. Miller who also teaches drama, and Miss Morell who teaches a mixture of drama and music. You can expect your lessons to be very creative and practical. And each one of us tries to make everything you do as fun and as interesting as possible, whilst developing skills such as collaboration, problem solving, and above all, confidence. You will learn how to create your own plays and music, you'll perform lots of drama pieces and plays, and above all, you will get to listen to and watch lots of exciting stuff from the performing arts world. At present, the department has 2 dedicated music classrooms, both with full sets of keyboards, a small suite of iMacs, a well-equipped and high-tech drama studio, and of course, full access to the main hall, which also boasts some excellent high-tech sound and lighting equipment. We work closely with Gwent Music Service, who offer lessons for guitar, drums, woodwind, brass, strings, piano, and voice. As well as the extra lessons, we're also proud to host regular concerts, performances and school productions to show off the talented young people we have in the school and to give everybody a sense of pride in what they've achieved through the performing arts. We're all very much looking forward to welcoming you into Cumberland High and hope we can get to work together in the performing arts department very soon.
Hello, welcome to the art department. As you can see, there's not a lot of people here at the moment, and we're just waiting for you to come join us. show you a little bit about what we do all the way through Kids Central.
Welcome to the Geography Department at Cumbrian High School. My name is Mr. Morgan. I'm head of Geography. This is Mr. Chapman, who's also a Geography teacher here, and he's also at Year 11. And on the end is Mr. Benson, who teaches Geography, History and RE in the department. Main topics we'll be learning this year, up until Christmas, we'll be doing map skills, which includes latitude, longitude, direction, grid references. After Christmas, we'll be looking at Wales, the home region, in detail. And moving into the summer term, we'll be looking at population and settlement in Wales and in the UK.
Okay, well, I'm obviously biased, but I believe geography is the best subject in the world. Excuse the pun. But it is really important that we actually understand the world around us and issues that are affecting the world today. So we'll study a huge mix of subjects, including major issues like climate change, world population, and deforestation of the rainforests. So I'm sure there's plenty that you can study, learn, and enjoy.
Okay, in geography, there are so many transferable skills that you can transfer from other subjects, including maths, English, and science. For example, in geography, there are certain activities that do require extended and descriptive writing. There are also tasks that involve numeracy, so data presentation and analysis, plotting different types of graphs, bar graphs, line graphs, and scatter graphs. There's also, in geography, a perfect opportunity for some exciting field work. We can actually go out into the community and the surrounding areas and actually see things that we learn about in the classroom for real, in real life. So I'm looking forward to all of those things, really. I'm looking forward to teaching you very shortly.
I'm Miss Collins and I'm Head of History in Cumbrian High School. And I'm just going to tell you a few of the things that you'll be studying when you arrive in Cumbrian High School if you choose to come here. So history is obviously the study of the past, which we've all done parts of in primary school. I should imagine you, lots of you have done the Romans and the Tudors and Henry VIII and his six wives. But we study a broader range of history in specialist history lessons in Cumbrian High School. So you'll start off looking at things like the medieval world, and you'll be thinking about the times of the knights and the Battle of Hastings. You'll look at the Tudors again in a different way than you did in primary school. You'll also look at things like the Stuarts, during which time a king had his head chopped off. You'll also look at things like the World Wars, and we've got some artefacts about the World Wars. These were dug up from the trenches in Belgium, and it's a German helmet and so on, which you'll see in the video. But also you'll look at things like going towards the modern world, and often also big topics like the slave trade, the Holocaust, big topics that make us ask big questions and help us realise how we got to where we are in the world today. So you'll be asking all these questions. You also develop your literacy skills, your communication skills, and most importantly, as you become teenagers, the skills to make a very coherent argument. So we look forward to seeing you. And I hope you come to Cumbrian High School.
Welcome to RS in Cumbrian High School. I'm Mrs. Bridgman, the teacher in charge of RS. You'll be studying a range of really important subjects when you come to us, if you choose to come to us. In Year 7, we have an introduction to the six main world religions, just to get you used to what we're studying. And then we get to look at the really big questions in life. What you think is right and wrong, how you think the world is, and what our place is in that world. We get to make sure that we are tolerant, important human beings who are really caring about the world and our place in it.
Good afternoon, Year 6. My name is Mr. Pollock and I'm the school ALENCO and also the school safeguarding officer. My main job at the school is to remove any barriers to learning that some students may have. Now, if you've been receiving some extra help in Year 6 at school, then rest assured that you'll receive that similar help when you come to us. And to get through that, we talk to all your Year 6 teachers over the next few months and we'll find out as much information as we need to regarding your any extra help that you do require, and we'll try and put that in place when you come to us. Now, to help us, I have a fantastic team of people. I have Mrs. Sims, who runs one of our hearing impaired base. I have Mrs. Beredith, who runs our internal ready to learn unit. Mrs. Nicolau, who runs the ASD base, and Mrs. Mosley, who runs our additional learning centre. Alongside that, we've got approximately 25 to 30 LSAs helping as well. So there's lots and lots of help. Now, throughout the day, if you need that extra help, that might take this. It may come in many forms. You might be withdrawn from some lessons, you may get some help in lessons, etc. So it's very, but we will know as much as we need to know about you before you arrive. If any parents would like to come and have a chat with myself, I say my name is Mr. Pollock. I'm available on the school website and also on email. Okay, so again, apologies we couldn't see you on this evening, but hopefully this video will give you some information. If you do require any more, then please don't hesitate to contact me. Okay, look forward to seeing you in September of next year, and in the meantime, if I do pop out and see you in the primary schools, that's who I am. So again, it's Mr. Pollock and I'm the ALENCO for the school. Thank you.
Thank you very much for taking the time to watch our virtual open evening video. If you have any further questions, please feel free to get in touch by email or by telephone. I very much hope that we will be working together in the near future. Thank you.
I think we're back with you now. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for bearing with us with our glitches. So we'll now hand over to everybody there. There was lots of information, lots of members of staff and perhaps some past pupils from your primary schools that you recognised in the videos. So obviously you may know lots of people that you can ask questions outside of school. But if there's anything that is really worrying you, bothering you, or anything that you'd like to ask us now, then feel free to pop it in the chat. If you're happy to pop your mic on, I think I've still enabled that. I'll have a little look now, but we can certainly pick up your questions in the chat if there's anything that you'd like to ask us tonight. Oh, we wait for the quiet now, Mrs. Abdullah.
No, please feel free to ask any question, no matter how small you may feel it is or how unimportant it is, because it's obviously it's important to you and it's important for us to answer any questions that you may have regarding the transfer to Cumbran.
Oh, Oscar's, okay, is there additional support for dyslexia? Oh, I thought I saw Oscar's name on there. Oh, my son is Oscar. Oh. Okay, so we can thank you, Oscar, for your question. So if there are very specific needs that you have and some support that you might be getting at primary school, we would have lots of conversations with your teachers at primary school about the support that you get and about what they currently do to help you to make sure that you're achieving your best in your primary school. And we would certainly look to try and put in very similar support and make sure that you have the opportunity to do your best here at secondary school too. So we'll have lots of information about you, Oscar, and be able to support you and help you in the best way that we can at school. We've also had a question about, Can you have your phone in school? Oh, this must be from a pupil. I'm sure this must be from a pupil. So a big, big change for lots of primary school children is that you are allowed to bring a mobile phone to secondary school. Now, our school policy is that you are not allowed to have your phone out in the classroom at all. It must be switched off and in your bag. If it's seen in the classroom by the classroom teacher, then they will confiscate it for that lesson and it will be returned to you at the end of the lesson. They'll keep it safe for the lesson and we will give it to you back at the end of the lesson. But if that keeps happening, then as a head of year, I would ring home and say, look, the phone is becoming a big issue and it can't come into school. We don't have that big an issue, to be honest. Most pupils will be respectful of the school rules and they just use their phones at break time and lunchtime then when they're out and about. But what I will say is if you choose to bring your phone to school, it is your responsibility. We do unfortunately have children whose phones have been knocked out of their hand or they've dropped it and they get very upset if it's gotten damaged. And unfortunately, if you choose to bring your phone to school, it is your responsibility to look after that. So it can be a little bit difficult and awkward sometimes, but you do need to make sure that you're looking after your phone properly. Okay, so there seems to be lots of questions popping up there. Okay, after watching the video, we're concerned about not knowing where some of the rooms are. Okay, and you will, the children will have an opportunity to have a tour of the school within year six. But on the first day of high school, they have a tour of the school with their form teacher. But everybody gets lost. Everyone gets lost. You will move around school with pupils that you're familiar with or somebody that's in your class. So you just help each other out to find your way around. There are always teachers around and about. So if you're not sure where you're going, you can ask a member of staff. Our caretakers, our cleaners have been helping pupils get to lessons. So there's always somebody who will help you. Lots and lots of pupils are very, very kind and very, very nice and will help you. We do always get one or two who are a little bit daft and think it's a bit of a giggle to send your seven pupils in the wrong direction. But most of our, it's just a giggle. That happened to them when they were in year seven. But most of our pupils are really kind and will help you get to your lessons. So don't worry about getting lost. Everyone gets lost to start with, but we will help and make sure everybody's getting where they should be. Let's have a look. Mrs. Abdullah is viciously typing here, answering some of your questions as well. Somebody's mentioned that they have pupils who say there's not enough room for pupils to sit for lunch, so they eat outdoors a lot. Okay, so under COVID conditions, we currently have an indoor space, separate indoor space for each year group to be able to eat. So, you know, the canteen previous to COVID could become quite busy, but we were never sort of made aware that children weren't able to sit. Some children choose not to sit in the canteen because it is very busy, but we would always make an attempt to ensure that all children have somewhere in the dry to sit and eat their lunch. Currently, there's much more space because, as I explained, all year groups have a separate inside space to sit to eat their lunch. So that has helped a little bit. They have a separate outdoor space and indoor space so that year seven pupils, when they go outside, they have a red grass area which is just for them, so they don't have to then be in and around older year groups either. And I know they quite like that. Let me have a little look through the messages that are popping up here. When will you find out who your teachers are? Lily Marie wants to know. You won't find out who your teachers are until you have your timetable on your first day at school. Form teachers, we do try to prepare in advance, and if we can, we'll give you an opportunity to get to know a form teacher. That isn't always possible because we do obviously lose some teachers at the end of July sometimes and then have new teachers starting in September. But if we can, we will let you know and give you the opportunity to get to know people before you join us. Okay. Do you carry your books around? Saren wants to know, do you have to carry your books? Yes is the answer to that for SEM. Some teachers will look after your books unless you have homework. If you're given homework, then obviously you will need to bring your book back to school in preparation for your next lesson with that subject. But if you have your books, then you have to carry them around. But lots of teachers, if you're not having homework, will look after them for you. Brooke wants to know, is the work easy? Right, Brooke, this is a really good question, because we like to think we challenge all of our pupils a lot of the time. If the work is really easy, there's no point in you doing it. If you can do it and it's really easy, we want to make your brain work really hard. We want to make you learn as much as we possibly can. So we have to challenge you. And so if your brain's not working, you're not learning. We have to make the work that little bit difficult to make sure that you're learning the most that you possibly can. Now, that doesn't mean it's going to be too difficult, because if it's too difficult, also we're not going to be learning at our best. So if there are things that you find difficult, it's really important that you talk to your teachers about that and let them know.